here is there's a lot you have to unlearn in the history, world history, American history. This is 2016, June 17th. Here is that lie still being told. It's still here. They refurbished it, made it brighter. But here's a lie saying that the Indians sold Manhattan to the European for $24 or something like that. Then they say $24 worth of beads. Here's the lie right here, still etched in stone. And you're supposed to believe this. In testimony of ancient and unbroken friendship, this flagpole is presented to the city of New York by the Dutch people, 1926. A lie presented to the people of New York. Columbus, Cortez, Pizarro, the so-called conquistadors, the Dutch, the English, the Spaniards. This is a lie. And right across the street is the American Indian Museum. Yep, that lie is still etched in stone, still being taught. There's much history one must unlearn. You have to tell your own story, Jeffrey Holder said, and many other scholars and great entertainers, performing artists have said, you have to tell your own story. But this is the Museum of the American Indian. This is Broadway, at the end of Broadway, where the 4 and 5 train stop right across the street. Around the corner is the 1 train that'll bring you down here. But it's live.
Walaikum salam. Alaykum salam.
How you doing, brother? All right, thank you. On the 22nd of April, 1625, the Amsterdam Chamber of the West India Company decreed the establishment of Fort Amsterdam and the creation of 10 adjoining farms. The purchase of the island of Manhattan was accomplished in 1626. Thus was laid the foundation of the city of New York. Isn't that something? And here is that lie, etched in stone. New Amsterdam and New Harlem, half of the island of Manhattan, going north, was named New Harlem, spelled Harlem with 2 A's as opposed to how it is spelled today with 1. But this is that lie right here, etched in stone, still being taught. As I said, you have to go into your history books and unlearn a lot of what was put there. Someone wrote a book, Lies My Teacher Taught Me, or Things My Teacher Didn't Teach Me. But this is another lie, still etched in stone. You get president after president after president, new Congress after new Congress, Senate after Senate, mafia movie after mafia movie. We go from John Wayne to Clint Eastwood, Harrison Ford, some of these other modern, Django Unchained, cowboy and slavery pictures. And the history, the lies that was given to us many years ago is still here, still etched in stone. We'd like to thank Dr. Yusuf N. Yikinen, my favorite historian, J.A. Rogers, Arturo Schomburg, for giving us a direction, a compass, a historical compass, some people like to call it. There was a saying by the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, Malcolm X also quoted it often, of all our studies, history best rewards our research. But this is the museum of the American Indian. At one time, it was uptown in Harlem on 155th Street by the cemetery, Trinity Cemetery. It was moved down here afterwards, and there were some indigenous people here vending, and they told some people going inside of this museum, question everything they tell you in there. So here's the museum, the National Museum of the American Indian. For those of you who wish to know, there's a collection of work sponsored by Kevin Costner with Native Americans telling their own story. 500 Nations. It was on video in the old days. I guess it's on DVD now. But there's a website. It's called a Native American Super Site. 500nations.com. So this is how do you get to the Museum of the American Indian, and Wall Street is straight up here on the right, across from Trinity Church. Trinity Church is down here, but of course they have their cemetery in Harlem. So directions to the Native American Museum in New York City will be, take the 4 to 5 train to Bowling Green. If something is wrong with this train, you can take the 1 train to South Ferry, which is down there, not far, about a block, and you can walk towards this direction and everything, they'll bring you here. This is where many of our grand parades start. When a Super Bowl, World Series, have someone in town of the stature of Douglas MacArthur or even Nelson Mandela. And they got some of the stuff right down here. Here are some things right here. Fashion Avenue, Wall Street, Gay Street. And at this time, we like to always, as we always do, pray for people before disasters, but we like to give a sincere, unhypocritical, unapologetic prayer to the young people who lost their lives for no reason, no way of defending themselves. We like to say a special prayer for them. That's the man right there, right here. This is the current president with Malcolm X. Of all our studies, history best rewards our research. God have mercy on all of us people. So we'll walk up here so you can get an idea how to get to Wall Street. That's where that street was named after an actual wall that was built to keep the indigenous people from retaliating. I said that before. That is the Wall Street is the best rebuttal to that monument we saw back there of a European handing a handful of beads to an indigenous person, saying that they sold this land to those people and to the English, I'm sorry, the Dutch, the Europeans, for $26 or a handful of beads. You get all kinds of crazy information and brainwashing, misleading information, deliberately misleading information, historically like that. There's the bull. For some strange reason, they like to take pictures on the bull in the front and the back.